Hey you guys, it's Peter, and welcome to my channel, Peterisms, where I tell stories of my life and just little things I've learned as I've grown into the person that I am today. And today has been kind of a crazy day. Do you ever have one of those days that nothing goes the way that you thought it was gonna go, and you had this strict plan and list of it's gonna go exactly like this, and then nothing goes the way that it's supposed to go, right? That's kind of been my day, and it hasn't been bad. It's been all good stuff. But I just got home a while ago and I wanted to film a bunch of videos, and I didn't realize how late it was in the day. My husband's on his way home, which is fine, but I have to leave to go to my meeting here in just a little bit. I'm gonna get my coin for 24 years sober tonight and then go out to dinner with Tanya, my best friend, and my sponsor as well. The three of us are gonna go out to dinner. So I'm real excited about tonight, and I wanted to get on here and make some videos for my different channels. And so anyway, Alex called and he said he was on his way home. Well, I was trying to get a hold of a friend of mine, and I hadn't talked to her in a while because I kind of told a little bit of a story about her on my Peter Mon channel. And so I just wanted to make sure that she was okay with that. And so she called me back and we were talking, and she got laughing and I got laughing. And we were just kind of, this is somebody that I've been friends with for forever, she and her wife. And so we were telling stories and kind of laughing on the phone, on the heels of me finding out that the actress and director Penny Marshall had just recently passed away, or she passed away today at 75 years old. And so I don't know, it was weird. Like, I was kind of in memory mode, if that makes sense. And you know, before she called, I was thinking about Penny Marshall. Now, what's strange about this, okay, is that I seriously, like, 2 or 3 days ago, I don't even know what day it was. Hello, boo. 2 or 3 days ago, on my vlog, I was talking about Penny Marshall, specifically Penny Marshall. I was talking about favorite TV shows of my mom and I's when I was growing up, and I was saying that Laverne and Shirley was like one of our favorite shows, right? And my mom and I would watch Laverne and Shirley all the time. So if you've never seen Laverne and Shirley, Laverne and Shirley is about these two women that are roommates, and they live in the basement of this apartment building, right? And all this kind of funny stuff that happens, and friends of theirs and things. And I think it's actually a spinoff from Happy Days, which I also watched with the Fonz. I was talking about all this kind of stuff in there. So anyway, but my mom and I, like, when I was younger, so that she could get me to, like, brush my teeth and wash my face, Bradley, wash my face and stuff before I went to bed. These dogs are wild today. Let me just tell you, they are running all over the place, and Pee-Pee is right here. But she would, like, we would, like, be in the bathroom, and she had this double sink deal set up, and we would, like, brush our teeth, and she we would sing the Laverne and Shirley song, and I always wanted to be Shirley, because I always thought, you know, Shirley was cool or pretty or whatever, which is funny, because in retrospect, I know I'm Laverne, if that makes sense. And, you know, Laverne drank Pepsi and milk, and she was always kind of different and quirky and funny, and, you know, I don't know. It just, I was thinking about that today, and then I was talking to my friends on the phone, and
yes,
and I was talking to my friends on the phone, and we started telling all of these hilarious stories. And these girls are two friends of mine that when the, the four of us, it would be my ex and I, and then the two of them, when we would hang out together, it literally would be night after night of storytelling, okay? And I've done videos about them before on, my Peter Mon channel. There's a story time over there called the Pink Tutu story, and it's one of the funniest things that has ever happened to me in my entire life. But we just have all of these stories of just little things that happened to us. And what was so funny when I was talking about it, was that they were remembering stories that I hadn't remembered, right? And I had to take my, it's winter and I have my sandals on. I had to take my sandals off to get a little bit more uncomfortable. So anyway, I was thinking when I got off the phone with them about my mom, and I was thinking about Penny Marshall and the connection with all of that, and how I loved Penny Marshall. And, you know, I was thinking about how we all remember people differently, you know, and I know that there are people out there that remember Penny Marshall from Hocus Pocus, because she was in Hocus Pocus. And I know that there are people out there that remember, you know, like fans that remember Penny Marshall from movies that she's directed. Like, I believe she directed A League of Their Own and many other movies. And, you know, and then there are people like me that remember her from Laverne and Shirley. And I think, you know, it's interesting when we grieve somebody or we're sad about somebody's passing, what we remember about them. And, you know, I tweeted out something on Twitter and I said, you know, rest in peace, Penny Marshall. Thank you for many years of, you know, laughter and something. I don't know. But that, you know, that is how I will remember her, is this person that just brought such joy and laughter into my life. Now, I didn't know her, obviously, on a personal level. I wish I had. I think, you know, people with true humor, people that have true comedic genius are people that I love to surround myself with because they just make me laugh all the time, you know? And laughter is something that just cures, you know, problems of the world. And it's, you know, just, it's a miracle solution, so to speak. And, you know, in all of this thinking, like I was talking to them on the phone and then I was thinking about my mom with Penny Marshall. I was thinking about these funny things, you know, that my mom and I would be in the bathroom and we would be like singing to the song, you know, we're gonna do it. And then, you know, I would fight with her and she would say, well, I want to be Shirley tonight. I'd be like, no, I'm going to be Laverne. And then I look back on that even, you know, that my mom was so cool. And my dad was too, you know, that at 6, 8 years old, like I wanted to be Shirley from Laverne and Shirley. And nobody was telling me that that was inappropriate or wrong. You know, what a cool way to be raised, that I could be whoever I wanted to be. And that was, you know, demonstrated through a TV show. And, you know, I was thinking about all of this and it made me start thinking about other things because I talked with my mom, like other memories that I had. And I often get on here and I talk about, you know, the last night that, you know, the last Christmas we ever spent together, or that night on the mountain, you know, or our recovery or our sobriety. I talk a lot about all that kind of stuff. And I talk about growing up as an adult child of an alcoholic and this and whatever. But I very rarely talk about, you know, the hilarious moments we had where my mom and I would get laughing because she truly was one of the funniest people I had ever met in my entire life. And it's interesting because I think I get my sense of humor half from my mom and half from my dad. They have very different senses of humor. My father is very sarcastic, cynical, and kind of dark, has dark humor, where my mom is just like, she would just say the corniest shit, you know? And it would just, like, we would just be sitting there and, like, to the point, like, she would start laughing to the point where she thought she was gonna, like, pee her pants, you know? She'd be like, oh my God, and we would be laughing, telling stories. I think that's the way going forward I want to remember my mom, you know? I think I want to remember her as a woman that when I came in the door, she'd say, ah, Peter, and she'd give me a huge hug, you know, and the smell of her. I think I want to remember her laughing. I think I want to remember her telling these jokes when we would be sitting in this very room, you know, and she'd be telling me stories and all this kind of stuff. And there was this one story that my mom used to tell, and she used to always tell it to me on Christmas. I don't know why. But when I was born, my parents they were very, very poor. My dad was doing his residency in medical school, and they lived in Evanston at the time because my dad did his residency at Northwestern University. And they were living in basically like a one-bedroom apartment that had like one small room and then one very small bedroom. Well, the bed was in there, and they had like two other sets of people staying with them because it was over Christmas. That's why she always tells me the stories at Christmas time. And it was like my aunt and my uncle and my cousin that's 3 years older than me, Caroline. And then it was like my grandma and my grandma's husband at the time, okay? So my aunt, my uncle, they gave me the bed because I, at the time, would have been 6 months old. And so they gave me the bedroom so I would be quiet and all that kind of stuff. And they put all these pillows around me on the bed so that, you know, whatever. And so in the other room, it is, and my mom was like, if you've ever seen Terms of Endearment, she always used to say, she was like Shirley MacLaine, where she would go in and check on me like, you know, every 5 minutes because she was worried something would happen to me. So in the other room, okay, sleeping on the floor and sleeping on couch and the couches and chairs and stuff, living room, okay, is my mom, my dad, my aunt, my uncle, my cousin Caroline, my grandma, and my step-grandfather, okay? Seven people sleeping on the floor and on the couches in this small little living room. And so my mom would get laughing so hard because she would say it was so hot in there and it stank of food because we've been eating and all this kind of stuff, and they used to smoke. She was like, you know, we smoked in that room because, you know, back in the days, people smoked inside. And she's like, you know, we're cracking the window and it's freezing outside and we're just sitting there. And she would get laughing so hard telling the story. And she said that at one point she goes, I went in there and I couldn't find, like, I went in the room and I couldn't find you and you weren't on the bed, and I started panicking. I was like screaming and screaming. Well, like a month before, a bat had gotten in the apartment. And so it's very much like if you've ever seen the, I think it's, what's the movie? Maybe Annie Hall. That where there's like a bat flying around the apartment. My mom would always reference that movie and she'd say it was very much like that. Like I was like, oh my God, a bat, a bat. And my mom's like hiding in the closet and my dad's trying to get this bat and stuff out of there, you know? So anyway, they couldn't find me. Well, my mom starts screaming and my dad thinks another bat is in the apartment. So he comes in the bedroom and he's like, where, what, what's going on? Where's the bat? And he's looking up and my mom's looking down and people are screaming and people are coming in the bedroom and nobody can figure it out and nobody's turning on any lights, right? And so the whole time I am like sitting, like I've like fallen off the bed and I'm like asleep next to like a pillow. Like I've like fallen like kind of like down onto a pillow and I'm like sleeping right like on this pillow, right? And nobody sees me because nobody's looking for me. My mom's like looking underneath the bed and my my dad's looking up and everybody, my dad's like, there's a bat. And he's looking at my mom's like, no, it's not a bat, but she's not saying what it is. So she used to tell this story and she would just laugh hysterically, you know? And I can just close my eyes and I can see my mother there where she is laughing so hard she can't stop laughing. And then I think about, you know, like the times that I've like driven around with my best friend Tanya and, you know, we'll just start telling something that is so stupid, you know? Or like recently I went to the casino and I've told this on my vlog with my good Judy Valerie and they were playing the Beach Boys and I very seriously, I looked over and I go, hey Valerie, I go, do you like the Beach Boys? And she started laughing and she goes, I mean, they're okay. I don't listen to them regularly. And so the Beach Boys became kind of like this constant joke of the night. And at the end, we were sitting next to each other and it was very quiet. It was very serious. And I looked over and I said, hey, Valerie, I go, we'll always have the Beach Boys. So now it's kind of like this stupid joke for us, right? And then with my husband, you know, we have, all of my friends and I have all of these like hilarious jokes, you know, kind of inside joke things. But my husband and I have so many of them, right? And like last night we were at dinner at the Cheesecake Factory and I said something and he said, it's like this like three word thing that goes back and forth and we just lost it, you know? And it's those moments that I want to remember about people, you know? And I think that in life, we have the opportunity to remember the sadness and the misery and all of that kind of stuff. And yes, those moments are going to come and we have to appreciate those moments and we have to pay them homage and say, you know, like this person was a great person. They did great things. And this is very sad that they're gone. And, you know, I believe that that is all part of the grieving process. But when we're past all of that, when we have felt our feelings, felt our emotions, we've moved through the main feelings of what's going on, especially at Christmas time or during the holidays when we're really missing people, maybe tell some stories of their funniest moments. Maybe tell some stories of their funniest times or things that they did that really just made us laugh that were so hilarious. I think that one of the greatest gifts in life is for people to bring joy and laughter to the world. I'm so blessed to have friends and family that surround me with laughter and joy. And I don't know what I would do if I didn't have that. You know, I think it's one of the reasons why people love comedy movies. My mother loved comedies, you know. She could have sat here and watched Caddyshack 5,000 times and every single time laugh her ass off like it was the very first time she had watched it. And I think that, you know, comedy is entertainment, but sense of humor is something that we all have. And I think that, you know, it's sometimes very, very important to appreciate the humorous moments as well in people's lives. And so I think at this time especially too, you know, it's not just, oh, I miss this person on that, but maybe tell some of the funniest stories. Maybe tell some stories that really make us remember what they were like when they were alive and the joy and the laughter that they brought into our lives. I love you guys, and I will see you tomorrow. Bye.